New at 6, it's happened again. Train horns forced to sound around the clock in another local town. The federal government again lifting a local railroad quiet zone in place for decades. 12 News' Kent Wainscott is in Wauwatosa with new developments at this hour in the fight to silence the horns in a couple of local communities. Kent?
Yeah, you're not going to have silence here in just a second because we're about to get a train with those train horns rolling through just alongside of us here at any second. You can hear the gates going down and the bells behind me. You know, Tosa Fest kicks off here in the Tosa Village right at this very moment. So there are going to be a lot of people out here this weekend, and they're going to be hearing plenty of those horns at these crossings. The Federal Railroad Administration tells me today that Tosa's request to restore its quiet zone is under review and a decision could come at any time. But these train horns have been a problem for communities all over the area this summer. And one community where they had it happen just this week has found a unique solution.
The silence has been broken in the village of North Fond du Lac.
Every time they come through, and it's just really loud and just gets really annoying.
The federal government has lifted the quiet zone at Lakeshore Drive, the only railroad crossing in town, leaving the horns to shake the walls at Mike Freund's business just steps from the tracks.
What's it been like this week, Mike?
Loud. Annoying. Extremely frustrating, actually.
And this crossing happens to be at a railroad switchyard, with trains moving back and forth 150 times a day.
It can only go so long. How long can you go without sleep? Just hear one going down.
But here in North Fond du Lac, they've decided to try something different to get rid of. If the trains continue to, every time they pass this crossing, get rid of the crossing.
Where'd the idea come from?
I thought of it just because, again, we've exhausted everything else.
Horning believes closing the street will mean no crossing and therefore no horns. But it would also mean a 3-mile detour for drivers.
Don't close the crossing. More train horns.
Much rather deal with the horns than the inconvenience.
But Mike Freund would prefer the quiet, even if it means closing the road in front of his shop.
I'd say shut it down. If they don't stop with the train horns, shut it down.
And we have a breaking news development in that story. Just within the past 5 minutes, the village board in North Fond du Lac has voted unanimously as a last resort, they say, to shut down that railroad crossing while they pursue the return of their quiet zone. It could happen within 60 to 90 days. The Federal Railroad Administration, meanwhile, tells me, as for these crossings here in Wauwatosa and this city's request for the return of its quiet zone, they're not going to speculate on when that decision might come. Reporting live in Wauwatosa, I'm Ken Wainscott, WISN 12 News.
All right, thank you, Ken.